is Aaron Weissman. Item 35 is the reappointment of Immacula Oliverio. Item 36, the appointment of Shirley Chang. Item 37 is the reappointment of Sheridan Singh as Destin. And 38, which is the appointment of Bobby Poste. Item 39, which is the reappointment of Woody Mailer. And item 40, which is the reappointment of Angela Davis. And I think that's the end of the human rights, but let me just check. Yes, all right. A motion, please. Moved by legislator Walker, second by legislator Shaffer. Okay, I see that we have several of the appointments and reappointments standing before us. If there are any questions or comments that you have, who has a question, who can? Yes, legislator, minority leader.
Thank you, Madam Assigned Officer. And Jerry, I don't know if you're going to, are you shepherding this, Jerry?
I am shepherding the issue. I haven't spoken to my sheep.
We had sent a letter that I thought Fran Becker was handling, getting it through, but we had requested, we had requested information. I don't know if you're familiar with that letter and what information we were requesting, but we had wrote, wow, this goes back to March. We had written back in March asking for more information in regards to the commission provide materials and how the practices and how they proceed, as well as understanding the governance portion in regards to how the commission's challenge was doing versus how they're doing that. And we never got a response to that letter.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry. I stand corrected. We got a response.
The speech of that letter.
But they declined to give us a decision that the board has rendered. Who's responsible? The county attorney. From the county attorney written to Mr. Kleins on April 21st.
Was that from Gospowski himself?
No, it was Nick Vivante.
Okay. And you're looking for additional information?
Yes.
Okay. Let your counsel send us another letter, and we'd be more than happy to move on that request.
Yes.
But I don't see any reason why it should hold up the actual approval of these appointments.
Just to be clear, we sent Mr. Vivante a follow-up letter, email, on the 21st of April once we received this letter that day.
And he hasn't responded to it?
No, he has not.
I will speak to him when I get back to the office.
Okay.
We will see that we get you the response and all the information that we can possibly give you within the normal course of proceedings.
Just to be fair, Jerry, the information that we were seeking is germane to the ladies and gentlemen that are behind you for their appointments.
With all due respect, legislator, the only information that is germane to their appointment is their qualifications, which you have received their resumes for. And whether or not the processes of the board is something that you wish to comment on or to submit further legislation on is something that is not appropriate before the legislature at this time. Is either an up or down vote on whether or not these people are qualified. The administration believes that they are qualified. They have submitted their resumes. They deserve the chance to speak to you today, and that you should render a wise decision and appoint or approve each one of their appointments or reappointments.
But Jerry, understanding what the commission is charged with, as well as understanding some of the folks that are being reappointed, it is germane, because if we don't have a greater understanding of what they're being charged with and how they're being supported with that charge, then how can we honestly, effectively assess whether or not their reappointment is deservedly so, or is it something that's tied to the administration not supporting them properly? That's why we believe it is germane. That's why we're trying to answer that question.
I hear you, legislator, and with all due respect, I disagree with you, and I would ask the legislature to consider the appointments at this time.
But Gary, just for the record, for clarification, you do realize if you're up for a reappointment, isn't your past service important on that appointment?
No, I would say that at this time, what is contained in their resume are the important factors that should be considered.
Of course, but if they served in that capacity for a previous set amount of time, wouldn't you want to know if they have been effective at that position or not?
In truth, I think that the issue that you're raising is not appropriate for the simple reason that it would lend itself to second guessing as to actually what was conducted by the board. The board has every right to be able to make the determinations and not have to worry about whether or not the reappointments will be approved by this body based on those decisions. They're charged with calling it as they see it, and how they call it is based on their background and their perception of the given facts in any situation. So I would disagree with you respectfully regarding whether or not their prior performance is relevant at this point. If there was an issue with their prior performance, that is something that should have been considered by the executive rather than by the
Jerry, legislature. It's all due respect, and I think I speak for the 19 members that are here, we are all judged based on our past experience and how effective we are as legislators. We are not judged based on a resume that we provided or continue to provide that talked about how well we did in our jobs before we became legislators. So in all due respect, I can't understand the rationale that if we're trying to understand what the commission is charged with to evaluate better how we should assess some of the reappointments to determine whether or not their past practice in this capacity is at fault versus a larger problem in terms of being supported by the administration, I don't know what we're talking about. Because I don't think anybody up here can stand on a record of what they did in high school or in college and talk about what GPA they had. They're all going to be evaluated on what they've done for the last 2 years or while we're in this term. I'm not too sure I understand your rationale.
I would point out there's a difference between the appointed individuals who would serve on the board and elected representatives of the people who are constantly in a position where they have to justify their performance in order to continue in their jobs. That's a profound difference between being an appointed individual and being an elected individual. Elected individuals are judged, while appointed individuals should be judged merely on their resume and what they bring to a given situation. And I might point out that this is a board that operates on a majority basis also, so that if someone is less than qualified on any given question, the other members of the board will be able to assist and come up with a wise determination of whatever questions are put before them. Madam Presiding Officer,
Jerry, before you start, asking the Madam Presiding Officer to move on, you should be respectful to recognize the fact that I wasn't done with my questions.
I stand corrected then, legislator. I did not realize that you were not done with your questions.
Thank you. I'm looking at minutes, Commissioner minutes from the September 24th, 2012 meeting, and 2012, yes, which some of the folks here that were on that board. That being said, I'm looking at some of the minutes in regards to Commissioner Williams noted that they needed, I'm just regurgitating based off the minutes, noted that we may need a special meeting if we do not act on the resolution today. These cases have been lingering for years. Onus will be to come back to us with this properly done and the commissioners and the county executive. When I read about some of these cases that have been lingering on for years, it brings concern. I mean, and this is some of the things that we wrote in our letter back to Mr. Vivanti that we have not heard yet. To me, this is extremely alarming that yes, it happened in 2012, which is almost 5 years ago, but the fact remains that when you read a statement where these cases have been lingering for years, it doesn't bode well to the effectiveness of the commission.
That's 2012.
Okay. So So tell us what happened.